Hello friends and welcome back to another easy PowerPoint animation tutorial, which is inspired by Aztec animation at dribbble.com. Many of you might already have guessed how we accomplished this Buddha animation, but we still recommend watching the tutorial till the end as we used a few tricks that you will find informative. First, we need a Buddha PNG image that we want to animate, and you can Google for that. You can also click on Tools and use Transparent from the Color drop-down menu to have a transparent picture. Copy and paste that image to the slide and make sure it is a transparent picture by applying a background color to your slide. Draw a shape on top of the picture using Freeform Shape from the Insert, Shapes drop-down menu. You can use the edit points to adjust the shape and the picture design will totally depend on how you draw and adjust the shape on top of the picture. Once you are done with that, select the picture first, hold down the Shift key and then select the freeform shape. Now, from the Shape Format tab, click the Merge Shapes drop-down menu and choose the Subtract command. Place the picture to the right side of the slide and half of the picture should be visible when we see the slideshow. Apply the left motion path and adjust the length. We are using a time duration of 1 second and setting the smooth end of 1 second. Even though we want the picture to move back, but still we are not using the auto reverse command as we want to add a bit of delay before it moves back to the same position. If you use the auto reverse then during slideshow, the picture will move to the left and then will immediately reverse back. We want to add a bit of delay before it moves back, so we are not using the auto reverse. Make more duplicates of the same picture and then change the color by clicking the color drop-down menu from the picture format tab. Repeat the steps to create more duplicate pictures of a different color. Place each picture exactly on top of the other and adjust their positions by using the send to back option from the picture format tab. You can see in the animation pane that each picture now already has the motion path effect because we applied the animation before making duplicates. That way it saves you a lot of time. The only thing you need to do is to add delay timings between the effects and we applied 0.20 seconds between each. Once you have the first slide ready, now make a duplicate of the slide through the thumbnail pane. As we want to move the backward picture first to the right side, so we'll change the effect position through the animation pane while adjusting the delay timings again. Finally, we need to adjust the position of all the pictures to the point where they stopped on the first slide. Before selecting all the pictures and moving them to that specific point, make sure to use the locked origin command from the effect options drop-down menu. When you use the locked origin and move the objects, then the motion path remains in the same position and doesn't move with the objects. You can watch our video about how and why to use the locked, unlocked origin for more information and the link is given in the video description and cards. Now, while having all the pictures still selected, click the effect options drop-down menu again and choose reverse path direction and then adjust the position pictures to the point where they stopped on the first slide. From the Transitions tab, apply 2 seconds timings for advanced slide for both slides. The The motion path effect duration is 1 second and transition timing is 2 seconds, so there will be a delay of 1 second before the pictures reverse back to their original position. That is the easier way to add a delay between the same effect without using the auto reverse. From the slideshow tab, click Setup Slideshow and make a checkmark on the Loop Continuously Until Escape option. Run the slideshow and it will now get played in a loop. Before ending this lesson, we would like to share another trick that we used in this presentation. Let's say we want to use the same picture as it is in the original animation, and you don't find it anywhere on the internet. What you can do then is to take a screenshot at the right moment by pressing the print screen button from the keyboard. That way, Windows will capture the entire screen and will save that to the clipboard. Paste the picture on a new slide. Crop the unwanted area and now we need to remove the background and make this picture transparent. For that, you can use the Remove Background tool from the Picture Format tab. You can watch our tutorial on how to remove background from pictures for more information. You can then use Mark Areas to keep and remove features and then click the Keep Changes button, and there you have a transparent picture ready to use. I hope you will find this video informative and interesting. Let me know by liking, sharing, and commenting on this video. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for notifications, so you don't miss the next video. Thanks a lot for watching the video and we will soon meet in our next tutorial. Till then, bye and take care.